questa difficoltà sia CFE Woods to support us. So from the I've started to CFE Woods before we Gerard and I will take a few questions and then we will eat and the team will go for dinner and then on to Las Vegas and yeah, we see the team and the Jennings. So I'd like to start with this CFE Woods before we take any questions.
Sa Burma na nasa wali ng abogado ng mga polis na ikwa. I'm back to drive this year, Mr. John Kong, and Fiji Airways Service Food, Mr. Gerard Beba, for the support here this afternoon. I would like to humbly apologize to the people of Fiji, to our president, chairman, CEO, and the colleagues at the Fiji Airways, to our sponsors, my teammates and family for getting it done. To represent Fiji as a member of Fiji Service School is the honor and my privilege, and one that I cherish greatly. I made a mistake and I decided to get my back on that morning. But I acknowledge the error of judgment and I'm very grateful for the decision I made. It is my hope that this occasion will be a learning occasion in this situation. To ensure you 100% clear before you pick up your keys to drive. I never intended to cause damage to the reputation or the legacy of the YGS. I'm truly sorry for this event and I hope you earn back the trust for you all through my future actions and my babies. Thank you for your continued loyal support. Fiji Airways Fiji Service. Everything we give for this team is to make people of Fiji proud. And team being a journey to USA for this next leg of series is coming up. We can believe for us to continue to show that determination and honor of Fiji. Thank you.
Another huge obstacle on your shoulder right now, the Las Vegas and Vancouver. Even though Fiji is there on the points table, but I believe in terms of the point scoring and try scorers, we are leading in terms of, but the main thing is the points. How are you adjusting this in terms of the point score, the most tries that you've scored, the most points, but still on the third ladder? And how are you focusing on this for the next leg?
We go about our business with the view that we want to win every tournament that we play. We've done that twice, certainly this season, but we haven't accomplished it twice. Obviously, as the team is always looking for the next challenge, the next obstacle, as you say. We are behind New Zealand and the USA. We know that going into these tournaments. Not a bad position to be in, because obviously you can have a crack at them as well. And we know that we've got to play well throughout our pool and play into the knockout stages to get that. But we don't change what we're about. I'm probably alluding a little bit to this gentleman sitting next to me. He's epitomised to me over the last 2 years exactly what it was meant to be a Fijian Sevens player. And when he was asked at a late stage to captain the side, don't forget, he wasn't captain at the beginning of the season, I was looking at Paula. Paula fractured his leg and this gentleman stood into the breach. And I think that the way he plays, the way that you've seen him lead the team, what he can do on a rugby field, I think people generally are amazed at. For him as well, he's been one of those individuals who has led our culture, has shown the players and supported those players who have sometimes shown in human errors as well. And I think that as a team, that's exactly what we do when one of ours is in trouble. Obviously, we have those conversations, but we put our arms around each other and make sure we learn together and we progress together. And as a team, we are at our best when we're playing the way that Fiji have always played, with that pace, that tempo that you see, and the likes of the offloads and the continuity skills this gentleman shows next to me. So I'm proud to have him. I've had him as my captain. Had a tough couple of weeks with it, but he's shown his leadership, and I think that everybody acknowledged that. That sort of leadership is exactly what you need when you go and play international rugby.
Thank you. Now, coach, how have you prepared the team in terms of maintaining discipline on the field?
Well, we obviously were quite hard within training sessions. You're always looking at the transgressions that can be made in foul of the law, but obviously about emotional control as well, and ensuring that players are showing those traits, those characteristics when they're on the rugby field. And if they do transgress, they're sent from the field immediately, and obviously we had issues in terms of using fines as we see them. We do have a code of conduct obviously within the team as well, and if they're found foul of that, then there's fines that are attached to that. But I always believed in, when you find yourself in positions like this, is that you as obviously me as the head of that and leading that, but it's bringing to the attention the individuals the learning mechanism which they can have from that. I'm not just here about, and John will attest to this, we're not just here about creating the best team we can do. We want to produce the best human beings we can through the learnings that they get from being in a sevens environment, and sometimes they're quite harsh, but it's the humility to understand that, it's the humility to learn from that and progress through. So obviously there's a lot of communication that has to go on in progressing this board.
Coach, are the two new inclusions, Iso and Aseli, the sacred weapons for these two outings?
Well, they've been included because of some of those things that I've just alluded to there. Their character they've shown in training sessions, when I've seen them play, how they have played, particularly Iso over a period of time, has come into training, how he's behaved in training, his work ethic, how he's willing to be coached and develop himself. He provides a little bit of a point of difference in the way he plays the game. Recently we played some games and I saw him and the likes of Daryl Lange on the field together, and it was like having two similar players, which is really good because obviously seeing the impact that Daryl Lange has had. Asa has a different way about him. He's quick, aggressive. He's a pain for anybody else in a contact area. And I know that that's a threat that every opponent who comes against us won't want. So I'm looking at those points of difference all the time and the reasons behind why they're in.
Just describing Modena Tangi's brother.
Yes.
What's the difference? Is he similar to his brother, or is it?
He's got a great work ethic, similar to Seven. I think that he goes about his contact work in a different manner to Seven. He likes his tackle, likes his back to his feet, getting above that ball, being a nuisance for opposition in those areas. He's comfortable with the ball in his hands, and he has pace as well. And look, he's 6'2", 6'3". And we're blessed in Fiji to have individuals who, one, are genetically blessed to be that size, but two, be able to move around the field quickly. And, as I said, he comes from a similar mould as Daryl Lange, even though he probably hasn't played as much 15s like Daryl Lange has as a 6 or a 7. But he shows the same traits in what he brings to the field.
Mr. Kona, just the update on Nanduba. What is
quite positive about Nanduba. Hopefully we will get an outcome on his visa soon, and we should be joining the team early next week. But as you know, we're starting to take more players now. We will be taking 14 players for this left, and even 15 next week. I think the board has sort of endorsed that we need to give exposure to our team as we build our base leading to the Olympics.
So, with regards to the talks that have been held with the embassy, pretty confident that Nanduba.
Yeah, we were quite confident that he should be on the field.
Coach, does that put a pressure on your team comparing this season? Three players undergone sort of like discipline issues. You had Nasil Sila, Tukunubula, and Nasoko. Whereas you compared to the Fiji Airways in Rua or the Flying Fijis, there have been no ill discipline in the team. Something within the Sevens atmosphere that causes them to have these issues coming up?
Obviously I'm not going to lie to you and say that it's the best way to be is to have issues with some discipline. I don't believe that it's anything to do with the energy in the group or whatever you want to describe it. I believe that there's a couple of individuals who have fallen foul, particularly when they haven't been in camp with us. We've talked about that as a group and how we have to mature as a group. And, I think that obviously a lot of the boys that are coming to our environments, into the Sevens environment, have had less exposure internationally around the world. Certainly when you look at the flying Fijians, there's a lot of boys who are playing overseas, and I've learned a lot of those traits and the ways that they obviously have to conduct themselves in international flights. And we've got to be hard on it as well. These boys realise that to live at that standard, they may have to make mistakes, but they're going to have to front it up as well. Running away from them is no answer to me. So I don't believe that that there's a huge discipline issue in terms of how we are as a group. We've just got some learning to
do. Coach, suppose Fiji wins this leg, do you think that will set the pace for the title race?
Absolutely. I think anybody would say the same thing if they're in that leadership position, and they do it. I mean, we're 4 points behind USA and New Zealand. We know that we've got to pull every stop out that we can, especially in the USA, where the USA played so well last year. We know the standard and the level that we've got to play at. We've got to get a focus about us as a group. And, obviously, part of my thinking in terms of Kali and speaking to Kali over the last couple of weeks is he's a good reason why that focus has been with us. His leadership with the players, letting them know exactly the standard that they've got to achieve, not just for themselves, but also for the people of Fiji as well. So we're very mindful of that all the time. But absolutely, if we win this one, obviously we're back in a position of strength. And pushing on to Vancouver, where we did so well last year.
Last question.
Just to add on to what Gareth said, the boys are in such an environment where they are constantly under pressure and things. Referee has set high standards, and you deal with those issues when they arise. We're thankful that we can encourage this. He was quite, he was upfront by staff of 2 incidents, and we are thankful that he's standing up and he wanted to do this to clear his name and ask for forgiveness from the supporters, and likewise ask the supporters to release them so that they can do the job that they have trained so hard to do in the last few years.
Sorry, just lastly, Coach. It's very cold in America and South America. Are the boys going to play some scrimmaging sessions or friendly matches before the game day?
Yes, we're due to play against France on Tuesday afternoon. I've seen the snow that's in Vegas at the moment. I've contacted the organisers as well to find out what that means in terms of training pitches and the like. But obviously it's a challenge for us. I mean, you know, it's 30 degrees here. We have to train at certain times in the day because it's too hot for us to train on times. It's going to be a completely different proposition when we get to Vegas. But the boys know what they've got to do. We know that, you know, just because it is snowy doesn't mean we can shy away from the challenge that we have. And my job, my role is to do is to create focus in our training. I ensure that when we do play against France that we get some learnings out of that, good and bad. Then we make sure we put them to get us in the best position possible for winning that tournament next weekend.
Coach, a message for the Fijian fans.
The Fijian fans is, look, we go about our business all the time to make you proud. As Kelly's just said there, you know, it's heavy weight sometimes on players' shoulders. We realise the responsibility we've got, but you know, we go out there every single time to die for the country, and we'll be doing exactly the same as we can.
Captain Kelly?
Can just